a part of me laugh. Oh no. We're gonna talk nothing very little sports with your host Jimmy, Jamie, or James. And now you know for sure that it's gonna be a blast. It's gonna be a blast. Oh yeah. This is the podcast.
I want to state for the record, off the top, this is actually me, not some well-edited pre-version of me. You funny scoundrels.
Oh, yes.
I go away to the Wymara for a week, and I was actually things that I saw on Twitter, and one of our fine listeners wrote and said, "Man, you barely even talked this week on the pod. What happened?" And I'm like, "What are you even talking about? There was no pod this week."
Oh, there was a pod.
And then I went online, and there it was. And the number of actual people that thought that I was part of that pod and was just not speaking was quite amusing.
You might say something about our listeners.
We should clarify. I suppose most of our listeners knew that. Stoff basically took little clips of me from other pods.
And
what did you guys have, a script? How did that work?
There was some script that yes. was used. And
Stoff, you put this together. How did this bad boy work?
Yeah, I cut a bunch of clips of you saying different things, and I threw together a little mock script that I thought we could go off of, and after a couple takes, we had something we could use.
Now, unfortunately, I've heard from the people at Apple that this was our most popular episode ever.
I have a new nickname for Stoff, Dr. Diabolical, because that's diabolical.
Do you think, we had this discussion, remember we've talked about when Tom broke on Saturday Night Live when... Dana Carvey did the thing about Tom Brokaw retiring and them yes. keeping him alive. Do you think if I died, would you guys continue to do the pod?
At least for another season.
Just using clips of me, and would anyone know?
No, listen, if we got the sponsorship, why not? You know what I mean?
Do you think the people at Untuck It would know?
As long as we have the Untuck It read, I think we're good.
Untuck It. Cool. Relax.
That was very clever. Once again, the genius that is Stoff. We should say that we are kicking it old school / new school. This is the first time we've ever done a pod like this, but kind of, sort of. Puffy and I are in the original throwback
yes.
season one episodes. We do all.
I think we did all
stuff. All of season one in this little closet.
Say about half a season. Yeah. Half agreed. A season.
Season one, we were all stuffed in this little room, including Stoff, right?
Yeah, Stoff.
Stoff would
here.
Sit between us.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, we were practically on his lap.
And I would be in the back, yeah, and Lester was up here.
Side with my guitar.
Yep. Yeah. You
know. So what they're doing, they're redoing the radio studio. Overdrive, our popular radio show in Toronto, is now going to be a TV show.
Yes.
So they're making a TV studio
like
for a radio show.
Like Leash Lunches, too, for the 2 hours.
Really?
Correct. Yeah.
So is all TSN just going to be radio shows on TV?
The thing you got to wonder is it goes 12 to 2.
Right.
And then they have a 2-hour blackout for, I guess, the afternoon show. Can't those guys get on TV, too?
what a sham
comes
that
back
is.
On TV.
Our poor buddy Matt Cause, they just won't put
just
him on
gonna
TV.
Be like,
Stoff, did you just make that deal to open that 2 to 4 window to tape the Rubber Boots podcast?
That's Rubber Boots Daily.
We yeah. should be live on
wow.
TV now.
We should.
That should something? Be a show. Is that Ken should. Volden still out there in the yeah. studio? Our senior producer?
Yeah, get him on that.
Yeah,
yeah,
I
that should
him.
Be, but then we'd have to do it every day. We can't well, screw
we
that.
Could, we can barely
well, no, no,
do
James,
one.
All the James, prep we have
we
all do. The tapes.
All right.
We'll be fine.
Guess which episode James was actually there for.
Anyway, so only Puffy and I are in this little broom closet, the old school. Stoff mm-hmm. is in his little normal position
yes.
outside, and then Lester we've banished to another little closet because there's only two microphones in here. So Lester's not in this, he's like in a soundproof yes. booth as if we were doing a game show.
And this yes. this is like, this room, I have to tell you, I mean, it's like hockey tape and pins. That's it. That's what's going on in here. It's crazy.
You sound great though, Lester.
But, you know, I feel great. You know, I have to say, I do kind of like the space to stretch out, relax, you know what I mean?
Well, I think it's easier for me to ignore you now.
Well, it's true, but I'll be honest with you, I'm so isolated, I might take my pants off.
Oh, wow. Huh?
Yeah.
All right. Interesting.
I still have a window into there. Oh, wow. Keep the pants on.
Will it be as impressive as Stoff in our Masters?
That's
new
true.
Jack
Masters.
Will you be able to see
it's the, actually now
the
said,
bulky outline?
People say hung like a Stoff
of a penis. It's a new phrase. It's a catchphrase. Anyway, fantastic job on the pod last week, guys. Good to know that I'm not needed whatsoever. That I've done enough quality material to last for years.
Exactly.
Let's get to the week that was.
Let's discuss the week that was with James the Rubber Boots Podcast Crew.
The week that was must be brought to you by my friends at the Wymara, seeing that I just came from the Wymara. Five lovely days and nights at the Wymara Resort in Turks and Caicos. How about that?
You lucky bastard.
Quick story before I got to the Wymara. So my family was down there when my wife and two daughters were down there for a week. But I had to do a speech in Calgary. Did I tell you that last time?
Yes.
So I had to fly out. I flew out on Friday afternoon. And I did the speech, and then I took the red eye back to Toronto, and then jumped on the flight to Turks and Caicos. So the speech was for these fine folks at Bear Pharmaceutical. Do you know that Bear, they don't only make the little aspirins, but they put all the pesticides on the fields, on the crops.
Oh, really?
Wow. Yeah.
They make our food grow big and strong.
Oh, healthy Bear.
Yeah, I was sitting there at dinner with the folks going, this isn't organic, is it? And they're like, oh no, this is far from organic. It's the opposite of organic, and we love it. So I didn't mention what my wife is into. You know that genetically modified? This is 100% genetically modified. Everything you eat here. See that banana? That's not a banana. That's a potato. So I do my little speech out for the fine people at Bear. A big bunch of farmers.
Oh,
just,
yeah?
Just a bunch of partying farmers.
Did they know who you were?
Yes, I think most of them did.
Yeah.
I mean, some of the why it was a lot of couples.
Got a couple.
So basically, they're clients. They bring in all their farming.
But were you
couples.
Like the main event?
Yeah, it's kind of
like
weird.
You were why they were there.
I wasn't the opener. It was like dinner and me. That's it.
That's amazing.
I know. It's always kind of scary too, because you know it's basically like stand up.
Yeah.
Essentially,
yeah.
Like you're just there to entertain them for 45 minutes.
Oh God.
So I have. You know, a repertoire of stories,
sure.
Many of which I've told on the pod or in my book that I go to for these things.
Yeah.
But you never quite know. Usually I'll know, like, if it's, you know, 20 to 45-year-old gentlemen who have a lot of beers in their hand, that's kind of the demo, right?
And was that what you had?
Well, no, I get there and there's a lot of, like, elderly couples.
Oh,
and I'm going, oh, is this guy, you know, and some of my stories are a little offside. I try not to cross a line, but they're offside.
Right.
But I was, the two really nice guys that brought me in there, I guess, were the organizers. I'm like, you know, what can I do here? They said, whatever you think is offside, go five times further.
Really?
Yeah, so that freed me up and I was
fine. Oh, that's great.
Wow, okay.
Yes, and so...
So you sold some Puffy stories then?
Oh, yeah.
I'm very big in the farming community at West with the older people.
Okay. So the point of this story was that, you know, Jimmy doesn't drink much anymore. And he's been trying to train.
Yes.
Of course, right? For the golf season. So I've been pretty clean.
Yeah.
And a couple of beers at dinner. Couple of glasses of wine, loosen me up for the speech, drink during the speech, one beer after, then I have to. So for me, like three beers, two glasses of wine, pretty much very tipsy.
You were humming.
Very tipsy.
You're feeling nice.
Yeah. So I go to the airport and I get on the airport bar. Brian Trache and a bunch of guys were there. They'd been up north doing some really good stuff with young hockey programs up there. Trots is a buddy, so another beer at the little airport bar. So now it's the red eye.
Yeah.
So the plane leaves at 12:30.
Okay.
And that my whole plan, I was in the
sleepy.
Pod.
Yeah.
Oh, I was so excited. Pod is always the best.
Yeah.
Have you ever been on the pod yet, ever?
I've seen you go into a pod.
Lester pod?
I've never been to pod, but
Stoff
my pod.
I've stared at one with envy.
Yeah.
Right.
My dream would be to be in a pod listening to this pod.
That's right. We should get like the pod to sponsor the pod.
That
like,
would be
Air
fantastic.
Canada, sponsored by Air Canada Pod.
Yes.
I can't even get you guys in a pod down to the Wymara because they don't do the pods on little planes.
Okay. Right.
Not a 737 Max, thankfully, but not a littler planes. Yeah. So anyway, so Jimmy's now gets in the pod where he was going to sleep for 4.5 hours. That was the whole plan. And I am drunk. And so I'm like, would you like a drink, sir? Yes, I would like one. I hadn't been Fun Jimmy in a while.
Yeah.
And
fun Jimmy in a confined space. Yeah, it was really weird. Good.
And everybody turned out their lights and went oh, horizontal. No. And I was like in the mood. I guess I had my ear pods in.
Yeah.
It's another pod thing. You know, what do they call them? The ear pods? The
earbuds, I think.
The earbuds, yeah. Yes. Sorry, they're not the... And I kind of forgot. I guess I was singing. I
pay like money for video of this.
I was rolling through like the Drake album.
Oh,
and I didn't realize I was singing loud. I'm like, summer just started and we're already done.
All these people paid good money to sleep all night.
The stewardess has to come up to me. I said, sir, you're singing quite loudly. And people are sleeping. And so that's the first moment that I got up, because I was reclined in my pod, but I wasn't horizontal.
Yeah.
And I get up and everybody is completely horizontal asleep.
Well, it is 1 a.m.
Oh man, it was funny. And then I dozed off. I kind of passed out.
Yeah.
And then I missed the breakfast. They served breakfast an hour and a half before the end of the flight.
Yeah.
And then I got angry. I don't know, AOL or AOK for me. Like she said, everybody was slept through it. I asked at the beginning of flight, and you had your ear pods in, so you didn't ask for breakfast. And I was like, I demand my oatmeal. So anyway,
how was the flight from Toronto?
So
to
that's the next step. So I had to my son, who was not supposed to go on this trip because he is in class at university.
Yeah.
He was over at the house on the Thursday night before I was going to Calgary. And he's like, Dad, I don't have much going on this week. So I'm like, buddy, you are coming with me. We're going to church. We're going to surprise mom.
Yeah.
Because the fine people at Bear had booked me in first class, there was only one other ticket left on the plane, so I had to friggin' fork out $1,500 for my kid to come first class.
Look at you. You're Jeez. Such a dad.
So so now we're both in first class, and he's 19, and he's like, bring it on. Yeah, and so now Jimmy's rallying, and Jared's rallying, and I get off the plane, and Mike, our buddy Mike, Dave Coulier Mike, he picks us up at the airport.
What a guy.
And what has he got? He's got roadies in the car.
Oh, God.
So by the time I got to the resort,
I went to the beach so loaded
and passed out for about 7 hours.
Day one.
You know what was funny though? It's cute. So we were going to surprise. Cheryl gets very excited. She loves her children. Sorry, that's Brooksy.
Brooksy. Yeah.
And so we said, when we get to the hotel, here's what you're going to do, Jared. You're going to go around the hotel. She's probably going to be on the beach because Brooksy's a beach girl over a pool girl. I want you to go into the ocean. And then I'm going to lure the three of them into the ocean.
Yeah.
And you're going to come swimming from out to sea.
That's pretty awesome.
That's awesome.
That's a great move.
And I'll be like, what the hell is that? Where's that guy?
Now,
holy crap, it's Jared.
You're making this plan while completely hammered.
Yeah, well, that was part of it. And Jared was right into it. So, but then they weren't on the beach. And so what we had to do was, I said, just sneak around to we were on the bottom floor this time at the lovely Wymara. And I said, just sneak around to the patio door and like stick your face against it and see, and Brooksy, She got a little terrified. she had a bit of a scream. I'm going to try and find it right here. But she was very excited.
Did you video? Did you put it on video?
Yeah, I video. Nice. I won't play the whole thing. But she, I missed like the first sort of second of it where she actually screamed because she thought someone was coming in to kidnap us, duct tape us, you know, pillage the entire Duffy estate.
Oh, wow.
So. Here's my son arriving at the Wymara. That initial scream. So it went from terror to, oh my goodness,
well,
my son
awesome.
Is here. Yeah, I thought that was pretty sweet. Anyway, fantastic week at the Wymara.
Yeah.
A little boat trip. You saw some of my, I did some Insta posts. A lot of people, do you think people hate me for my Insta posts?
No.
Just me.
I like the, you imagine we're going to post the crap out of it when we're down there in October,
oh,
all of us?
Oh my God. I think it might be a live stream the whole time.
Just live Insta the entire trip.
Live Insta the whole time.
Yeah,
so good.
We had a fantastic time. I spoke through your week. Was your week good, Puffy, Lester, Stoff? Anything exciting besides doing the pod without me?
My week's all about children's hockey.
All right, and your son's got a hard hat.
Hard hat for hardest worker for Austin for his team. And then Barrett's team won big game, so they got Friday night. If they win, both teams in the semifinals.
Wow, that's a big deal.
Go Bulldogs!
When you're in that.
Yes.
Time as a dad.
Yes.
There's nothing bigger you feel like than your
kids. Yeah, like I think right now I would rather the East York Bulldogs win
the championship, mm-hmm. then the Leafs win the cup.
Wow. Yeah. Wow. That's some dad power.
Yeah.
I was so nervous watching those playoff games. Like, and then it's over and you go, that was ridiculous. It's like bantam double A hockey.
Last night,
like
people
that.
Were going crazy in the rink. It was a lot of fun, but yeah, again, it is only kids hockey.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. That's the week that was brought to you by our friends at the World. Oh, sorry. Oh, yes. You know, it's like he's not even here.
Well, like, I forgot to kill his
listen, letter, yesterday was my birthday. I'm very, but I actually.
39, happy.
39.
35, I think.
What's the quality of your life?
My quality of life is just great. You know, I'm happy to be here. Everything's rolling along. But I actually shared the. I just wanted to shout out to my cousin Nicole because I shared the day with her, and she had a milestone birthday as well. So I want to say happy birthday to my cousin Nicole.
Mm, nice.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
What's Nicole do?
Nicole's a teacher, actually. Mm-hmm. Actually, a little bit of sports. She used to teach with Carl Subban, PK's dad.
Oh, he was a principal, right?
Yes. Yes.
That's pretty cool.
6 degrees of Lester.
That's right. That's right.
That could be a new segment on the show. Yeah. We have real ages, and then we have our podcast ages.
Exactly.
Because we have to, the advertisers want us to
skew younger.
Skew to a younger demographic. So Lester on the podcast is
37, I believe.
I just said 39, but we'll go 37.
37.
Puffy on the podcast is 31.
Yes.
Stoff is 26. Stoff's 26. An up and coming.
Yeah.
And would I have to be the senior member of the podcast?
Yes.
41.
41 years old.
41 years old. Our real ages, a lot of people don't know this. Puffy is 61 years old. I actually am 41. Stoff. What are you, Stoff? I don't even know how old you are actually. What's your actual age?
I am 34 years old.
Wow.
What a little baby, eh?
34.
A baby ass producer.
I know.
We have a lot of stuff. Stoff was working hard this week because he sent us a variety of things for our next segment, which is something we call Things That I Saw on Twitter.
Freaky pigs, strange chicks, world affairs, polar bears, fake news, nice shoes, big boobs, jack dudes, all of these things and more as I sat on the shitter. Things That I Saw on Twitter.
Things That I Saw on Twitter is brought to you by our friends at Untuck It, and there's a direct tie-in. We thank Dave. Pens fan 7.
Yeah.
We're big in Pittsburgh. Dave wrote in to let us know that he stopped by the Untuck It Pittsburgh store this weekend and told the salesperson that the Rubber Boots pod sent him, and they all looked at him like he was crazy.
I don't think we've made it through all the stores.
No,
as far as...
I know. I mean, I think we're big with the Untuck It people, but I don't know if we've
like
spread...
at a senior level.
Right, we spread North American wide. Do you think they have any posters of us up in any of the Untuck It stores?
Would be fantastic. No pants. Just shirts.
I think when we get to doing, we still haven't gotten around to doing our episode with our Untuck It shirts on. When we do that, we'll get a poster, and those will probably be in the Untuck It stores, 100%. Right?
Listen, so. I can't imagine they would pass up that golden marketing opportunity to have us model those shirts.
No, exactly. It should be, should we do it, though, like all unbuttoned and Stoff again not wearing pants?
Yeah.
Because that's the seller.
I think it's the only way. Nobody's wearing pants.
The apparently, they like the Polish sausage.
What is wrong with you? I just said you were 37, not 14. So we thank Dave. That was our first. What else did you have here on? Here's one. A prized pigeon has been sold to a Chinese buyer for a princely sum of 100. And what is it, Stoff?
It's $1.88 million.
Jesus.
$2 million pigeon. This pigeon has been compared to Lionel Messi of the pigeon racing world.
Now, it says hashtag Armando. Is that the name of the pigeon?
Yes, Armando the pigeon.
So now, is this one of those...
pigeons race?
Homing pigeons? Like one of those pigeons that brings back like a message or whatever?
It's not a carrier pigeon. I think they actually have pigeon racing. So I looked into this a little bit, and you guys will be surprised to find this out. There is also doping in pigeon racing.
Wow.
As people give the pigeons performance-enhancing drugs.
Wow. And so they do the testing.
Yep.
Pigeons are amazing little birds, though, right?
I thought they were dirty birds, right? Isn't a pigeon...
What do you mean, like slutty porno birds? No.
They're whores, James. No, like I thought they were like you can get... they carry disease and such.
Oh.
I don't know. I mean, I don't really get my facts from real places.
But you know, like, the pigeons will fly miles and fly back to you, right? You know, I
I thought that was like...
There's a song by the Tragically Hip called Pigeon Camera, one of my favorite Tragically Hip songs. Where's my pigeon camera? By now
were you singing that? Were you singing
anywhere?
That on the plane?
Yes, I was. Please, the person in pod 2A, shut the hell up!
Mad would you have been if you were on the pod in the pod and some guy was singing at 2 a.m. You would have been so mad,
angry. Especially songs you don't like.
But then I was thinking, did people recognize me when I got on the plane?
I'm pretty sure they like, did.
That's the TSN. Yeah. So pigeons. Anyway, pigeon cameras in the war.
Yeah.
Because Gord Downie was a big history buff.
Yes.
They would attach cameras to pigeons and send them over enemy lines to take photos. And then the pigeons wouldn't take the photos.
I'm picturing the pigeon. Click, 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 click.
Obviously, if you like one of those.
Suck it, Nazis.
So the pigeons are
back all cocky. Oh they weren't giving performance enhancers to those guys? You don't know what I've seen, man.
The pigeon's talking to his boss. He's like, Pete, I put this one on portrait mode. It's spectacular. See how I soft focus the background? And you can just see the net. You can see the swastika. It's so focused.
Oh, God.
You see him up there fluttering, taking pictures. Nobody notices.
That's the thing. How did the Nazis not notice the
just look
the
up, guys.
At the camera.
Part of the camera around his neck.
No, they were stealth. So they have those little cameras. I just went and clicked all the time or whatever. You put them on timer. They were pretty smart back in the 40s.
For sure.
And the pigeon, it would take, or maybe it was video. They have video in the 40s?
They barely had TV.
No, they didn't have video in the 40s.
They had video. Video existed, you idiots.
They had still existed, movies
like they put it video, but they had film.
But they
didn't
trust me to a pigeon.
There was no GoPro to put on a pigeon.
You know what I mean?
I think this is all bullshit.
When they're experimenting this and the film camera is too heavy and the pigeon like, falls into the ocean. Damn it, we lost another one.
His neck just snapped.
Armando, he was worth $1.88
million. And that's in 1920s money.
So anyway, so this is a racing pigeon that was worth $2 million, stuff?
Almost $2 million, yeah.
Oh, Jesus. Wow. Remember Mike Tyson had all the pigeons?
Yeah, he did. He trained
a bunch.
Yeah, because I remember the Jay-Z song. All the pigeons take flight. Remember, he was talking about Tyson.
Yeah, you know your rap lyrics.
I'm really throwing a lot of rap in here. So congratulations to Armando.
Yeah.
That's the thing. Everyone always makes a big deal about like the NCAA not paying the students. I don't think this money's going to the pigeons.
Yeah. Armando's got a little fur coat on.
Do you think Armando's in the same damn cage as all the other pigeons, or do you think he gets some sort of benefit out of this?
And you think they put him out to stud?
Can you stud pigeons?
Yeah, you have to be able to. Can you get
a pigeon expert on the line right now?
I gotta believe
if they're a dream analyst, that'd be perfect.
Yeah, I gotta believe there's some type of a high end feed he's eating pigeon feet.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah.
Imagine, though, he rolls in with his Beats headphones on. Hey, what's going on, everybody?
Can I ask you a serious question? You said put out to stud. How do pigeons make love?
I have no idea. I assume.
How do birds make love?
I assume with their
cock. Have you ever seen birds make love?
I'm reading up on it right now. It says they have to be 6 months of age to be sexually mature.
Ooh.
Wow.
Pretty young.
But how do they? Does it say how they? Just Google how do pigeons make love.
I can't wait for HR to see this.
This is the one that gets us canceled. I'm sure of it.
Stoff gets called into Kenny Bolton's office. You have some unusual searches here, Stoff.
Yes,
we're not going to judge you for your interests, but
I even took some time on one of the sites myself.
It was fascinating. Is there a pigeon red tube? PP hub? Pigeon porn hub? I'll move on to the next one while Stoff is finding out how birds make love. Mm-hmm. Bill Walton.
Yes,
NBA Hall of Famer.
Yes.
Legendary basketball analyst. I guess he's in Bill Walton. I guess he was talking maybe to reporters. He says, I stopped by the Statue of Liberty today and thinking about freedom and the ability to go for it all. Bill Walton is in Las Vegas. He was standing outside the Statue of Liberty at the New York Casino in Las Vegas. Do you think he...
The 60s were a blast, man.
Whoa. How many people do you think go to Vegas and think that is the Statue of Liberty?
Oh, I'm sure many people. Or the Eiffel Tower, too.
Or the pyramids.
Or the pyramids, exactly. As I was about to say.
The Luxor.
You can knock it all off in 3 days, as Puffy and I did last year at the Cup Final.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
we're not going to Egypt anymore. No.
Who needs to?
Why?
Bill Walton. That's pretty awesome.
That's fantastic.
Also, another tweet from Bradford today, something I don't follow, but Stoff does.
Oh,
that's his hood.
The Bradford.
St. Patrick's Day ride check nets $250,000 worth of illegal weed up in Innisfil. And they have a picture of the gentleman. There's like large bags of weed.
I'll
here.
Tell you, I was driving up and down that highway the whole day. I did not see those.
You were pulled over on the side fixing your latest breakdown.
my tire.
The funny thing is, the story says it was a regular stop. The vehicle comes through. There was an overpowering smell. This is the cop being quoted, of fresh cannabis coming from the vehicle.
Wow.
South Simcoe Police Constable Carl Jarvis told Bradford today on Monday. They got the exclusive. Jarvis said he could see cannabis leaf readily available throughout the vehicle, clearly if it's in boxes like that. And lo and behold, inside the 2017 Dodge Caravan, 29 kilos of illicit marijuana packed in three large boxes.
Wow.
Do you think these guys just thought it was all legal now?
Yeah, like, I'm pretty sure they thought that this is, well, yeah, no, they
we can do whatever the hell we want now. That's what everybody
but why can't they? If the man can make money, why can't the regular person?
I'm not going to disagree with you on that, but there has to be regulations.
Really?
Yeah. Puff, did you find out if the pigeons, how the pigeons have sex yet?
I do have the bird porn information here if you want it. All right, so reproduction in birds may be quite complicated and lengthy. That's the first sentence, so we'll skip ahead here. During mating, a male bird presses his cloaca against his mate's cloaca and passes the sperm from his cloaca to hers.
Are you saying that the cloacas are identical? Is that possible?
Well, it has to be a male cloaca on a female cloaca. That's what it says.
Oh, so they just call the same thing.
Yeah.
That would be interesting if we did that as humans, if we just called them the same thing.
Yeah, it sounds like dry humping. That's what I'm picturing. Like a bit of like...
Well, actually, have you ever seen the birds like flying through the air? Do you think that it happens in the air at all?
Ooh, that'd be tricky.
Wouldn't that be something?
Because I've seen many birds playing like that.
The air hump.
No, I think they're doing it in the trees, like everyone else.
Or unless they have a 5-star nest somewhere they go to in Wymara.
We were in, I think it was Hawaii, on one of our trips, and two turtles were making love. And on one of the boats we were on, and the little tour boat guy said,
This is just off the starboard side here. You can see a couple of sea turtles having intercourse. With sea turtles, the male has to stay inside of the female for 19 hours.
Oh, Jesus.
Wow. I made up that number, but it was something like that. Like they just sit there, and they're floating on top of the water, and it just grinds hard.
But are they actually making some movement in and out?
That was a little throbbing.
I mean, yeah, you don't want to get too. If you start jackhammering away, it's gonna. Wow. You might not last long enough. And
we're not
17 happens.
Anymore.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
We have really gone downhill here.
No. I think this is stuff. This is educational stuff.
Exactly.
How many listeners?
Discovery Channel is only on the third floor.
That's right. That's right.
Someone down. Oh.
You can write at the Rubber Boots Pod because this is stuff I didn't know.
Yeah.
You know, we always feel like we're common. We don't pretend to be smarter than the average people. You listen to a lot of these podcasts. I listen to, the Daily,
Daily.
New York Times. What's his name? Michael Barbaro. He's so smart with all the political knowledge. We are men of the people.
Man of the people.
And so we try to
like, I bet teach. You most of our listeners don't have any idea what they just learned now.
Right.
That is true.
They still have no idea. They're all dumber.
No.
We are fountains of useless information.
Yeah. Anyway, that was a special edition of Things That I Saw on Twitter, brought to you by Untuck It.
The moment I saw her, I knew it was on. Her eyes danced just as much as her smile. She looked me up and down and studied my every move. And as she grew near enough, she said, "I like your shirt." And I said, "Thank you, babe. It's an Untuck It." Untuck It. Cool, relaxed, comfortable.
Just like Roddy.
cool, relaxed.
Yeah, people are definitely f***ing to that song.
I'll tell you what. Fries. I am, you know what, it just dawned on me that I have written somebody something that one of the foremost voices in Canada wrote.
That's right.
That's pretty...
That's right. And you know Roddy has sticking his cloak up against... Is it cloak?
Cloaca.
He's sticking his cloak up against a lot of cloacas in his time. It's never a good look when you untuck a long, bulky dress shirt. That's why Untuck It makes shirts specifically designed to be worn untucked. A casual shirt, not too long, not too short. And if you visit the Pittsburgh location of Untuck It,
be sure
to ask for the promo code Rubber Boots, and they will kick you out of the store. They will kick your ass right the hell out of there.
Demand they give you your savings.
Steal your shirt.
And as they're escorting you out by your Untuck It collar, say, "Don't do this to me! This is where I learned while pigeons made love! Don't you listen to the Rubber Boots Pod!" Oh, you guys, we were told me you both have Lester and Puff.
Yes.
Both brought along material this week. You guys really came into your own while I was gone.
Yes.
You've brought your little A-hole or A-hole K segments.
That's right.
Is it A-hole or is it A-A-A-A-OK?
Lester, since you're in the isolation booth, you may begin.
Thank you very much. I will start this off. So, last night I had to take my dad. My dad and I went just for a little trip over to Fairview Mall to take care of some things for him. And we're coming out. So I parked. And I didn't park back into a spot. So I parked. And there was another car in front of me at the time. Okay? So we're leaving. And I go over to look, get in the car. And there's no car in front of me. So I'm thinking, okay, I'm just going to drive through, go forward, and get out of the parking lot. My lights are on. This car's on. My lights are on. It's at nighttime. Everything's cool. There's two other spots available on either side of my car. And what does this guy in a minivan do? Come. He parks right in front of me. So I have to back out of the car.
But he's on the other side,
he's
right?
He's on the other side, right?
But he could have come through himself to your side?
He could have come. Now that I'm gone, he'll be able to come through if he wants to. But my point is this. There's two other spots available on his side that he could have parked in.
Oh, okay.
Right? So I'm getting ready to drive out, and this guy pulls in and blocks me. Now, it's his right to park in that spot. But you see what I'm saying? He had other spots on the either side of me.
He's like those entitled pregnant women I had to
Exactly, exactly. I know. So to me, what are you doing? You can't you see you got other either side? Why would you park in front of the car that's ready to go? To me, that's an a-hole move. What do you guys think?
I think that's just parking at Fairview Mall. It's a war zone.
How does he know you're going to go forward would be my only question. Thing. Yeah, I mean, I pull that move too, Lester. Like, nothing excites me more than coming, besides pigeons making love and seeing that on pigeon porn tube, that of being able to drive out. You get the free spot. You don't have to back out. Boom, you can go forward. That's very exciting. But I don't think he's supposed to know that you're necessarily going to do that.
Yeah, he just saw the spot and he wanted to park.
But there's two other spots available. You see what I'm saying? My lights are on. It's clearly.
Did you think about aggressively roaring your engine?
I thought about getting out of my car and slapping him, to be honest with you. Because I just thought it was so obvious that I was getting ready to leave.
Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I think for the first time for the first time in the history of A-hole or A-OK, we're going to make you the A-hole.
Unknown minivan driver, I feel your pain.
Just back your ass car up. Yeah. You're a grown man. Yeah. Back your ass car up and get out of there at Fairview Mall. You know, you've done it a million times in your life. Just pretend there was a car in front of you.
It's not forward driving.
I feel that you would be frustrated, but I don't think we can call that guy an a-hole. I don't think he was thinking. And you also don't know, you know, what kind of day he's having. Maybe he's got all sorts of stuff going on in his life, right?
He just saw the parking spot wide open. Three, he's going to go in the middle.
Boom. He just took it. All right.
That's fine.
And you'd lit it up for him nicely so he could see the lines.
There is one other possibility. Perhaps he pulled in waiting for Lester to reverse out so that he could pull all the
way
through.
That's true.
But then does that make him an a-hole?
No, it makes you an a-hole first getting in his way.
That's strategic driving.
Yeah, he's just aggressive.
Yeah, get the hell out of there and let him move in, Lester. Jesus.
He assumes you're going to back up because that's how you were going to be the first place.
Yeah, I don't know. Okay. My bad. I'm sorry.
No. We appreciate that. We're all in those moods and park spots when people do dumbass things. Puffy, you have your own version.
There is a chance that there could be two assholes in this group.
Oh, this will be interesting.
So this is I have a somewhat bad habit of playing inappropriate music while driving for the children in the back seat. And I don't always realize that the song, because I just am bopping along. So there's one song in particular that my boys have taken a liking to. And I've agreed to play it if they have big hockey wins, which they did last night. So this
is
play
song. It in the car.
In the car after
the
wins.
Game. All right.
And here's the song.
If I hit it one time, I'm a pipe.
Oh, yeah.
If I hit it two times, then I like a. If I three times, I'm
Is it a little bit offside? Yeah, I was thinking that. I'm like, does everyone do this with their children?
Are they quoting the lyrics back to you?
They're laughing hysterically every time there's a swear word.
Okay, so you can play the whole thing.
I
think we get the gist.
that's the part that they love.
What's before getting some money?
With me and get some money.
Perfect.
Wow.
Yeah.
So I have some experience in this. You can turn it off now.
I thought it would be a good soundtrack.
Oh, a little background? Sure. When I had little ones, now mine were even littler than you. So, you know, I had 3 and 4 years. So I would say they were all in the car seats. So maybe Jared 4, Darian 2, Gracie baby.
Yeah.
And that was Eminem.
Yes,
Eminem was big, and I was big into Eminem.
Yeah,
and so I would play those songs relentlessly, and I was kind of thinking, they're not even paying attention, right?
Yeah,
they got the DVD in the back there going on, watching, Toy Story 2 or something like that, Madagascar, and they caught on very quickly. It was like, because I noticed one day they're walking around the house like Darian's 2 going, tonight I'm cleaning up my closet. I'm sorry, mama. I didn't mean to.
Oh, my God.
I'll never even kiss him goodbye. Now I just wish the motherfucker would die.
So you're worse than me.
At least Puffy's kids are getting money.
Wow.
So I would start, I learned to just add my hand like a DJ on the volume button.
Which I do, dude.
And I would just turn down every swear word and then turn it back up. Turn down every swear word.
But then they fill in the lyrics.
Well, no, but you have to get them then beforehand. I'm introducing you a new song, children, but you have to turn down the volume.
That's already passed by for me.
Well, aren't there clean versions of those songs?
Yeah, but they're not as good.
Do you know what a sign of age is? That when you think that the... like you've heard a song on the radio or something, and that you don't realize that there's actually a dirty word in there instead. And then, like, Jared's playing plugs in his phone in my car one day, and I'm singing along the song, and it's like, that says
I thought it was funk.
It was just dance on my version. And then we danced.
But I figure that my kids are they're learning swear words now and I don't want the swear words to feel like, I mean, it'd be a little hypocritical of me to be like, you can't swear, but I don't want them to swear around me. Mm-hmm. But the songs, I think, are okay. But I also...
I gave up at about 14, 15, because it was just impossible.
So 7 and 9 might be too early.
Yeah, I said, don't use the language around the house, but you can't stop them from listening to that stuff. I think it's impossible on the interweb. So are you an No, I think you're A-okay.
I'm A-okay.
Yeah, but I would try to work the ball.
Lester, do you think I'm A-okay?
You're okay. It's a parenting decision.
Okay.
So. Yeah. Stop.
Not like me. I'm an
I think you're good. Your fathering skills, I don't know.
That won't be the first time that's been said.
So Lester's just tried to park his car. He's an asshole. Puffy's exposing his children to horrible knowledge. And
you're A-okay.
You're fine. You're fine, Puff. That is a special version of A-hole or A-okay, brought to you by our friends at idrinkcoffee.com.
Middle of the morning, can't keep my eyes open, cause I got to have a cup of Java. I got to have a cup of Java. So I better log on to idrinkcoffee.com. drinkcoffee.com.
I was getting a little concerned that we were getting a very sponsor heavy, very theme heavy on the show. Somebody made a claim to me on Twitter that we were one Lester's themes representing 80% of the show.
That is certainly not true.
Lester's going to be bringing that to his next contract negotiations with the Rubber Boots Pod. No, there's nothing wrong with that. I just wanted to say that our friends at Puckpedia, Hart is, they've been, when we signed on with Hart at the beginning of the year, it was for a half a season. And he's very busy getting his site going and pouring all his money into that. We're going to have a relationship. Oh, that sounded weird. We're going to have, Hart's going to be part of our show again at some point in time, but he's focusing on that. And, well, we'll miss. We had a lot of fun with Two Truths and One Lie.
Two Truths, One Lie.
It's great.
But I feel Weeksy killed it.
We kind of milked it till the end. Yeah, Weeksy killed the segment all by himself, didn't he?
Yep.
He brought up the same thing as, what
he
did
tricked
he do?
Us.
Yeah, he tricked us.
We don't know if he sang in front of the Queen.
Yeah.
Yeah, he pretty single-handedly killed the segment.
I don't know if I ever got one right.
I don't think,
I think I went 0 for 9.
Anyway, we continue. Hart's a big fan of the show, and so we ask you to continue to support Puckpedia.com, and I think somewhere down the line you'll hear him again here on our podcast. But we do have What You Watching.
What You Watching. Just between you and me, what you streaming on your TV, let me see. What You Watching. Action, drama, comedy, what you streaming on your TV?
I had to bring What You Watching into this week because last night I had a night off back at the, me and Brooksy back at the estate, and I put on Free Solo.
Oh, yeah.
Did we talk about this film on the pod at all?
I don't know if we did on the pod.
Okay. I really enjoy the climbing films I've found. I found them full of action, and maybe it's because things I would never do. And so I have great admiration for these guys that do things that I would never do.
You know, I do think like about the, like climbing a mountain would be something that I'd like to do, but I don't want to actually have to do all the effort and work.
So I watched a great movie, which I'll highly recommend, called The Dawn Wall. And basically, El Capitan is in Yosemite National Park. Was that California? Washington? Somewhere down there?
No.
Anyway, El Capitan is like the climber's paradise.
We should really know where Yosemite National Park is.
I think it's in California, isn't it?
I'm somewhere? Like, is that where Yogi Bear is?
So El Capitan is basically this sheer face, 3,000 feet high. All right?
Okay.
And in the movie The Dawn Wall, Tommy Caldwell tries to climb a part of El Capitan which was deemed unclimbable. Basically, Puffy, this wall is straight up and down. Okay?
Yes.
It's straight up and down. There's no mountain. It's just straight up and down.
Wow.
Like there might be, and the little ridges that they climb on are little 1 centimeter.
Like the crevices things?
The crevices are, I'm talking about, you can fit your fingers. Maybe look at the width of your like index finger. That's how big the crevices are, and that's what these guys climb on. It's ridiculous, like how strong their hands and legs.
But
have to
they
be.
All got to be like a buck 35.
You know, they're lean guys.
Yeah,
super strong. So Tommy Caldwell in The Dawn Wall climbs this impossible part of it now. But it took, I don't know, 15 days or something.
Did he
like
have
that.
Ropes?
Yes.
Okay.
So I thought, wow, this is an amazing movie. Mm-hmm. And then somebody says to me, "You got to watch Free Solo," which won the Oscar this year. I think is Best Doc. So this guy, his name is Alex Hunold, I think it is.
Okay.
He climbs El Capitan.
The same mountain. Or
not,
the same...
He didn't take the same route.
Okay.
But basically, with no ropes.
What?
So there is this thing, and I've heard of these guys before, but Free Solo is a thing, right? It basically, it's mountain climbing without any ropes. And basically all the best guys in the world that do it are dead.
Really?
Yes, because they keep doing it until they slip
they
once and they die.
Yeah.
And so this movie, which I can't recommend highly enough, Free Solo, is about this guy, Alex Hunold, deciding whether to climb. And there's the intricate sidebar pieces to this are the fact that all his buddies, including Tommy Caldwell, is one of the guys in the movie, and the guys filming the movie, like, they're like, okay, how are we going to film this movie where we might film our buddy dying? And how are we going to film it? Like, if we get in the way and, you know, there's cameras on the side of the mountain and let's say we click a camera at the wrong time, we cause him to die.
Yeah.
Like, you have no, and they identify about 4 parts of the mountain which are, like, really super hard. And, like, they show him practicing with ropes. Obviously, he spends about 3 years practicing. And, like, there's one part of the wall where you have a choice whether you have to jump, like imagine the side face of a wall. You have to jump sideways and grip onto this thing because there's not a grip for 4 feet. You have to jump sideways, or you can sort of karate kick your way up there with one leg, try to press that leg against it and flip your arms over. So he has to decide, and they keep showing him falling with the ropes.
Oh my God.
It's insane. Wow. It's insane. I can't even begin to describe, like, I think the guy has not a death wish, but it really it gets into his personality. Like his parents were not loving and affection. His dad died. And obviously, I think you have to have issues to do this.
Yeah.
Not agreed. A death wish per se, but they did an MRI on his brain. And I'll probably say this wrong, but I think it's the amygdala part of the brain, which is responsible for fear. Mm-hmm. And in the MRI, it showed it had no impulses on his head.
Wow.
Like that part of his brain basically wasn't functioning, so he had just no fear of anything.
Oh, mine would be hyperactivity.
Oh, my goodness. Well, because I say this because you and I are fraidy cats.
Yeah.
I think all four of us are fraidy cats to an extent,
I don't
right?
think I could climb up this wall.
I couldn't have gotten 20
with,
feet.
With, like, pedals and nudges.
With ropes, I don't think I could have gotten 50 feet up this wall. With ropes.
Honestly, I think even if I started to get up, once I got high enough where I could die by falling,
right.
I would almost immediately die because I would get so scared.
You'd die.
I'd break concentration.
I do wonder if it's the same. Like, I mean, you think about this guy, you think about race car drivers, the other sport. I mean, you are taking a chance, and you know every time you get in the car, you do a race, whether you could practice, you could die, right? So, yeah.
Very, look, there are dangers. You're right, but this is still not the same as one step.
Yeah.
You're like, your chances of dying, like, I would think when he sits down at the bottom of that mountain, starts up, it's 50-50 he's going to die, probably.
You'd think it would be better than that.
More that he's going to die?
No, more that he's going to not live. Because why the f*** are you doing it? If it's a 50-50, you're crazy to do that.
And he's got a girlfriend. That's the other part of this movie.
Oh, so, he must not give two craps about her.
Yeah, well, he told her to like leave a couple days before. She's tried to have this talk with him and say, okay, so would you stop doing this? If you thought, you know, you'd have a longer life to be with me, would that stop you from doing this? You know, like basically saying, do you love me enough?
Yeah.
And he goes, no. But he does love her. Like, obviously, this is the first girl that he's sort of settled in with. But what a film. Anyway.
Did you
How long
that?
Is it, James?
That's like an hour and a half, hour 40, doc. Right.
Did you hear that story about the mountain climber who died just recently and his mom had died on almost the same hill?
Damn.
Like, she died like 33 and he died at 31.
Really?
Both mountain climbing. But it's like, obviously, you know, he got it from his mom, like that drive to do it. But
really?
Imagine.
Do you have any desire like to climb Everest?
I do. Like, not, I don't have a real desire. I mean, mm-hmm. I do look at the people who do it and think, wow, that's a real huge accomplishment. But like, there's no way I would risk my life.
Yeah.
And you could legitimately die, especially if you don't know what you're doing.
Chris Cuthbert climbed a big one. Maybe Kilimanjaro or something like that? Like,
yeah, that one. I
want to say that, yeah.
I think that one might be easier just because I think a lot more people can do it, but still takes, you know, things can go wrong. But.
Right. Anyway,
Yosemite is in California.
Hey, baby, I nailed it.
And Yogi Bear does live there.
Boom.
Is Yogi Bear real? Yosemite Sam was from, too?
Yosemite Sam?
Yeah, he also lives there.
Thank you, Puffy, for your information. We've learned so much on this podcast. Let's go. Maybe we should have a new segment. What have we learned today? What? We'll go around the house. Mm-hmm. Lester, what have you learned today?
I've learned today that maybe my time in this pod is up.
Well, Lester, interestingly enough.
Well, I noticed I'm further away from the group this week. So,
Stoff, what have you learned today?
I've learned that pigeons like to get it on.
Yeah. What is it called again? The clucky?
The cuckold?
Cuckold?
Cloca.
At the cloca.
Cloca cabana.
A lot of pigeon banging.
Puffy, have you learned anything today from the show?
No, not really.
I've learned that Lester is a horrible parking lot person.
Yeah.
That you're a horrible father.
I've heard you're a horrible drunk.
Yes, you don't want to be next to me on a pod. And
like, imagine that was someone's first pod experience.
I know.
Like
they've been saving up. They got the upgrade.
Like,
boom.
They could have reason to, like, fight you.
Mm-hmm. Do you know we're going to Spain this summer? And
all pods?
This is a terrible thing to say, but it was Rouge
Yes.
Rouge to Barcelona. I couldn't, and I couldn't fly. I'm so spoiled now, and I'll admit this freely, that I could not bear the thought of flying Rouge to Barcelona. So we
a 7-hour, 8-hour flight?
Like 8 hours. So it's we changed our itinerary and flew to Rome, and I kind of got a deal, I got one of those Air Canada sales, and I booked all of us in pods. So my little daughters are getting in pods.
Oh, nice. My God.
And I was going to just book myself and Brooksy in a pod and stick the kids in the back. That's what everybody told me to do, but I feel too guilty.
No, I think it's good.
Does that make me a good father or a ridiculously bad spender?
Because you're traveling to Rome with the children on mm-hmm. the pod, you have to treat them like Romans, so they are allowed to drink.
Oh, they're already drinking.
They should be boozing in that whole pod. I want the whole Duffy clan singing away.
You have no idea how broke I am right now. Okay, so when you...
it's amazing.
I love Turks and Caicos.
No one lives more week to week.
It's unbelievable.
You're like an NBA player at lockout time.
It's unreal. So the problem now, I realize, with my whole family, they're not little kids anymore. It's one thing to have little kids. Now you have adults.
Yeah.
So I'm going to give you an example. Coco Bistro is our favorite restaurant in Turks and Caicos.
Yes.
Probably the best restaurant in Turks and Caicos. Mm-hmm. Turks, lovely place. It is expensive place.
Yes.
And now, so five of us at Turks and Caicos. Jared drinks. Mm-hmm. Darian's 17, but that's legal in Turks, or might as well be.
Yeah.
So she's a gamer. Gracie swears she's never going to drink. So now I have four drinkers at the table.
Yes.
At an expensive restaurant. And the rum punches and margaritas are flowing and the vinos are coming.
Oh, yeah. Especially, they're pounding them back.
And it's bring the desserts and stuff like this. So I believe that the total at Coco Bistro that night was, I'm going to say, $5.88 or something like that.
Okay.
So that was, we drank a lot.
Yes.
So that's not terrible for five people. It's not insane.
But for your family of five, that's a lot of money.
But then I get the RBC Visa with the conversion to Canadian dollars.
Oh, hold on. That was $5.88.
That's U.S. I'm paying U.S. dollars. So I can't remember exactly, and someone could do the math for
that's
me, but it was like $7.49.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it gets a little pricier then.
I went to Acapulco.
Yeah.
At 21 years old, Mike Thibodeau and I on a university vacation, and it was for the week, 2 weeks, 2 weeks, hotel.
2 weeks.
2 weeks, hotel flight, $5.99.
Oh, God.
2 weeks, hotel flight, and we ate every day at KFC. So that trip probably cost me about $1,000, booze included.
Yeah.
Nice. I spent
took 9 years
almost
off your life.
$800 on one dinner on this vacation.
Jesus.
It hurts.
Well, imagine what it's going to be like when we're all down there, how James is going to be rolling out the wall.
Because you got to treat us like your kids.
That's right.
Well, we're gonna go to Coco for sure.
Coco.
But I don't know who's going to pay for that.
We'll have to do a credit card roulette. But you have to put in like seven cards.
And mine gets to be expired.
Yes.
We'll all bring expired cards.
Stoff gets drawn. He's got a beautiful free trip to Turks and Caicos, but he gets $1,000 dinner.
That's
he just leaves in tears.
I don't have Armando money.
Anyway, what I've learned this week, don't have children, or a lot of them. Maybe stop at one. Be like Stoff and his lovely wife, Violetta.
Raise a racing pigeon instead.
That's right.
They can make you money.
That's right. Because the children, when they get old, they're going to break you. They're going to break your bank.
But they got to be getting close to where they're going to start paying their own way, right?
Well, that's not happening yet.
Jared's almost a man. He'll have a job in 3 years.
He's looking for a job. Darian doesn't have a job yet. It's an expensive damn thing.
Within 10 years, they'll all be paying for you.
Yeah.
Or they'll all be living in your house for free.
Well, that was an evil laugh. Ding, ding, Lester. Ding, 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 ding. Thanks for listening to this week's edition of the Rubber Boots Pod. This was live. Imagine if this was all taped too. This was all sound bites from previous editions of the pod.
It'd be out by Christmas.
Pretty impressive.
Where will we get all those pigeon clips from you, James?
Thanks for listening, folks. We'll talk to you next week.
Hey, how are you? I got a question that I really wanna ask you. Wait, don't hang up. I need to know, so I'm gonna try and push my luck. Are you wearing your rubber boots tonight? Are they purple, yellow, green, or black or white? Are you wearing your rubber?
Are you wearing your rubber boots tonight?